I learned very early in life that a woman was supposed to sit in a corner and not work towards progress in education, career, sports, etc. I rebelled against this philosophy silently, and when funds were the source of my lack of education, I ensured right through my education till I completed my B Pharmacy degree that I was awarded scholarship and I was funding for myself financially. If not for this luck and opportunity, I would today have been an uneducated woman who may have been smart but converted to uselessness due to lack of opportunity. It was during these growing years that I realized that financial security for a woman is prime. Unless I ensure my financial security, people around me are likely to push me around and my ideals and dreams are likely to be shattered. So that at earliest, I started work and earn money while I studied to ensure my financial viability. Actually, I started working in 2015 as I was fortunate and my family also required financial support that time. Since then, I have been supporting my family for all these years. My support extended to my family in all their issues from food on table to studies and their personal growth and development. As part of my dream, I wish to have every sibling to benefit from studies like I did and enjoy the fruits of successful career in their own life and bring financial security to their personal life. But over the years, it has dawned on me that I have been used as a financial support without regard to their personal lifestyle, wastage of funds, and enjoying life without realization of the cost of earning such funds. My finances were being drained till I realized that I need to change my track and manage my finances better without emotional drains. First of all, I feel very proud and blessed to be born as a woman. It gives me the strength to provide motherly love that only a woman can provide and fulfill. But the journey so far has been quite tough, and this has made me stronger for my future. I am thankful for meeting my soulmate and now look forward to better times ahead in the future. Some points I would like to make about being a woman and the hurdles we need to overcome. My personal story about the scope and how this has elevated me to a higher standard of health and blissful living. As every woman knows, women are endowed with comparatively less physical strength, but women are very strong mentally, emotionally, and spiritually. This is our strength, and our convictions drive us to success. Irrespective of our status in life, whether in corporate work or personal life stories, where the challenges are different, difficult, and a life challenge to overcome to survive. Secondly, as part of our reproductive ability, we are endowed with periods, which are our greatest strength. But most women around the world believe that periods are a bane as they suffer the pangs of period time, feeling weaker, drained, mood swings, headaches, tummy ache, cramps, terrible, t- it's terrible for some, and sometimes unwanted odors as well. Some suffer from anemia as they lose a lot of blood during extended period and greater loss. My personal experience with periods has been what I refer to as normal, with some form of pain, some irregularity before they regulated themselves to the usual monthly cycle, and I resigned myself to some discomfort, suffering as the norm for a woman. But as I started to learn and practice scientific Surya Namaskar, my observations about my periods were to change drastically to pain-free status and very slight discomfort with slight mood changes, which were so subtle, but I did not bother to worry about it. Again, my Guruji directed me to consider Shivambhu as part of my personal growth. Even though I was averse to it, as I thought, I pushed my body and noted the following changes within a few months. My periods changed to infinitely subtle feeling of flow, with no pain, no mood changes, no noticeable weakness, and feeling different. This has been observed now for nearly an year, and I am sure this will be the story of my life now, having experienced such bliss during periods as compared to what stories I hear from my sisters in society. My dream is to work towards their personal rejuvenation in this area and thus make a contribution towards improved women's health. I work with all people, men, women, children, as part of my propagation of better health using scientific Surya Namaskar, yoga, true yoga, dietary advice, and personal fitness advice to assist people with weight loss, fitness, and better health. Some women's problems of PCOS, PCOD, thyroid, obesity, etc. are some of the frequent presentations. I get immense satisfaction every time a success story travels through our organization. Most of the time, it is a long personal journey from 9 to 18 months before they smell the taste of success and become a changed person, ready for a new beginning. Some of the common challenges for most women are focusing on their health, finding time to devote to their personal welfare, time for exercise in their busy schedule of work, managing the home, family needs, and children. It has been observed that women will put themselves last in the chain, and hence difficulty in personal progress. Same is the story with finances for their personal welfare. They at times consider withdrawal from programs due to financial constraint and gain sacrifice their personal gains at various points in the cycle. A very interesting observation: every woman in every scenario is working their butt off to overcome all the odds thrown at them, whether financial, emotional, mental, physical, and is always aiming to keep the family unit united under extreme conditions. Hats off to this woman. My role has been a lot of counseling, as they are looking for a pat on back, encouraging words, some direction, and some tips which they are always willing to apply for their personal growth and welfare. Trying to guide them through their personal difficulties and showing them the light at the end of tunnel. This itself brings great success and joy, as they have now seen in the way. A woman is always practical. Under COVID conditions, life is about online programs and personal classes under protective social distancing conditions, with due care for everyone. Like any woman's motherly attitude, we are aware of online weaknesses and limitations, but we are rising to this challenge with various modalities of videos and better communication using technology. We do owe a lot more to personal compliance, as personal interaction is missing. Presently, we have international exposure with students learning from us in Bharat, Australia, Qatar, and the US, etc. We are involved in sponsoring a weekly series on YouTube titled Freedom from Disease, which is currently running and expected to be completed in few months. All these videos are very valuable for your personal health. We aim for people to be empowered to ensure good health and to be available for any further advice as required. We have uploaded videos on scientific Surya Namaskar and its depth of grades. Our organization is trying to be at forefront of health developments in the traditional yoga, Surya Namaskar, meditation, diet areas at present time. I am progressing myself in yoga with a master's program underway. I have started meditation for myself. I progress steadily in Surya Namaskar with presently being able to practice 18th level of 70 level of difficulty within the scientific Surya Namaskar grading system. I would like to grow further. Besides, I am learning true yoga as it is used to be taught in ancient times. I wish to offer true yoga classes for the benefit of my students in due course. This is a very interesting question. Of course, true yoga is about performing asanas with your own muscular ability and not with props, support or use of hands. I shall show you a photo and a video and describe them to you. Looking at Padmasana, which is considered a fairly basic asana, when I learned it, I used to practice using my hands to pull my legs. But my guru advised me to consider fully independent action of the legs, as Padmasana is control over all the leg muscles, large and small. When I tried to perform the asana without hand support, I was struggling. Guruji convinced me that within 2 to 3 weeks with practice, I will be able to perform this exquisitely, and today I can do this with ease. I observe others who learn struggle initially, but based on my education, I provide confidence to them that it will also pass with practice.
Now I have observed that the small muscles in the groin, pelvic area are now stronger for this technique of the asana practiced in true yoga style.
The second part I shall discuss in this photo of Padmasana in Shirshasana. This is quite difficult. With every asana in true yoga, you learn to maintain the asana with minimum level of muscular involvement, ensuring maximum of unwanted muscles are relaxed. During this process, one need to hold the asana in place, means sthir, for few minutes. During this period, one must perform complete breathing using all four parts of the breath fully: Purak, Antarkumbhak, Rechak and Bahirkumbhak, which means breathing in, holding your breath, breathing out and holding your breath again, while trying to maintain a relaxed body and mind. This is true yoga.